Assalamu alaikum. Today lecture will be about hypoxia during VV ECMO. When we had patient hypoxic and all other parameters failed, we will go for VV ECMO. So how can we solve the issue of hypoxia on VV ECMO? The lecture today will speak about hypoxia, physiology of hypoxia during VV ECMO, and how different factors affecting it. We should differentiate between two terms used in clinical practice, hypoxia and hypoxemia. Hypoxia means that there is low oxygen supply to body tissue and the patient shows signs of hypoxia as increasing lactate, low SpO2, clinical signs of hypoxia as agitation, irritability, tachypnea. The other term is hypoxemia, and this term shows that there is low oxygen content in the blood, but the patient didn't show any signs of hypoxia. Hypoxia on VV ECMO. It's defined as SpO2 will be less than 85% or when PO2 persistent less than 50 mm mercury in two arterial blood gas sample at least 60 minutes apart while the patient is on VV ECMO support, also associated with increased lactate level. Through troubleshooting of hypoxia, we need to define some terms. First term is rated flow. Rated flow is written by manufacturer on the each type of oxygenator, and it is blood flow rate at which the blood entering the oxygenator with saturation 75%. But at that time we should have hemoglobin concentration 12 gram milliliter, and we giving oxygen in the sweep gas 100%. So the blood will exit the device with saturation of 95%. In this diagram, we will see rated flow. Of all these oxygenators, the blood entered 75% with hemoglobin concentration 12 gram per deciliter. Then we will see if we use ECMO flow less than rated flow, so the blood will come close to saturation, will come close to SpO2, close to 100%. If we use ECMO flow equal to rated flow, the blood will come also 95%. But if we use ECMO flow more than rated flow, so the blood will not be good oxygenated and there will be less SpO2 and the patient will have hypoxemia. Four elements are affecting oxygenator function and they are component of rated flow. SpO2 at the inlet of the oxygenator, sweep gas, if I tune sweep gas, ECMO blood flow and hemoglobin concentration. If we fix the three and change one of them, so we will see the effect on oxygenation and oxygen transfer in the next few slides. Starting from sweep gas, or if I took from the sweep gas, the first case we give 100% for 75 saturation SpO2 at the end of the oxygenator, so the blood will coming at 95%. But if we decrease FiO2 from the ECMO side to 60%, so the blood will come from the oxygenator 80%. So the effect of FiO2 as the same from the ECMO side is the same as FiO2 from mechanical ventilation. One factor is oxygen saturation at the inlet of the oxygenator. If we also use the same ECMO flow, the same FiO2 from the ECMO site, and hemoglobin concentration 12 in both cases, if the oxygen saturation at the inlet of the oxygenator 75%, it will come 95% if it's met the same rate of rated flow of the oxygenator. But in the other case, if the oxygen saturation is 60% at the inlet of the oxygenator, so the blood coming out from the oxygenator will be 80% and the patient will be hypoxic. factor for affecting oxygen oxygenator function is ECMO flow rate. So if we increase ECMO flow rate a liter per minute, and all other factors are fixed, so the oxygen transfer will increase. For example, if we use 2 liter per minute, so the oxygen transfer will be 150 ml per minute. If we use flow rate 5 liter per minute, the oxygen transfer will be about 325 ml per minute. So every time we increase the flow, the oxygen transfer rate will increase. If we speak about hemoglobin concentration, in this curve, we will find that if the patient has hemoglobin concentration 12 gram per deciliter, and if FiO2 100%, and also SpO2 at the inlet is 75%, we will find that oxygen transfer will be 340 ml per minute. But if hemoglobin dropped to 8 gram per deciliter, with the same flow, 5 liter, and with the same FiO2, we will find that oxygen transfer will be dropped to 225 ml per minute. And why hemoglobin is very important, it's a player of important role in cardiac in arterial oxygen content in the equation of hemoglobin, multiplying by 1.34 multiplying by SpO2. So the main component, a very important component in oxygen content and oxygen transfer, is the hemoglobin. The question is, how did blood oxygenated on VV ECMO? How saturation on ECMO calculated? First, this equation has 4 important parameters. First one is EF, which is the effective ECMO flow, cardiac output, post oxygenator saturation, and it is oxygen venous oxygen saturation. This equation is divided into 2 parts. The first part is the part taken by the ECMO circuit and oxygenated. So that's why we multiplying the effective ECMO flow and the, divided by cardiac output, multiply by post oxygenator saturation. Second portion of this equation is a part which bypass the ECMO circuit and go directly to the lung to not be oxygenated by the oxygenator, and that's why we multiplying by venous oxygen saturation. Now we are going to summarize causes of hypoxia on ECMO. Circuit-patient interaction, presence of shunt, cannula configuration. If the problem in the circuit itself, a problem will be an oxygenator, ECMO blood flow, or presence of recirculation. Patient factor like tachycardia, sedation, fever, and anemia. Causes of hypoxia depending on the previous equation, it's very simple. So post-oxygenator decrease in oxygen saturation. First, gas failure, oxygenator failure, high ECMO blood flow, low FiO2 from the ECMO site, low effective flow from inadequate blood flow, presence of drainage insufficiency, recirculation, increased cardiac output, which occur in hyperthermia, sepsis, agitation, decreased oxygen venous saturation, and anemia, hyperthermia, and shock. In this example, we show that this patient has a cardiac output 5 liter per minute, only 3.5 liter per minute going for ECMO to be oxygenated, and 1.5 liter per minute didn't pass the ECMO and going directly to the heart. If the patient has no native cardiac lung function, so about 13% of venous return will pass through the vena cava without oxygenation. This is regular patient and will not suffer from hypoxia. Take example, this patient is hyperdynamic and cardiac output is 10 liter per minute, 10 liter per minute, and only part entering the ECMO circuit to be oxygenated and taken by the ECMO is 3.5 liter per minute. So the total amount of the blood entering into the ECMO is 0.35 per liter, and 65% from the cardiac output didn't enter the ECMO and didn't get oxygenated. And this blood will pass through the inferior vena cava without oxygenation. And if we assuming that this patient has severe lung function, hyperpulmonary shunt, we should expect that he will develop severe hypoxemia. We should note that the presence of shunt, meaning of shunt, means that a portion of venous return that bypass the ECMO circuit and not oxygenated by the circuit. Treatment of ineffective ECMO flow to cardiac output ratio. If the effective ECMO flow is less than very low and the cardiac output is high. So to increase ECMO flow, we should optimize the intravascular volume, increasing the intramuscular volume. Also increasing the speed, or add another cannula if the cannula is small and the drainage pressure will increase. To decrease cardiac output, we should treat the liver using sedation and analgesia. We can use short-acting beta blocker to decrease cardiac output. Part to treat decrease in oxygen venous saturation, we should treat anemia, correcting hyperthermia, and treat the underlying cause of shock. This is a reference I used besides ECMO also red book. Time, and you can post your questions in the comment below.